I don't look at golf as 18 holes. I look at a golf course as 85 acres of potential fun. I'm looking to bring families together so they can have fun, they can be fit, and they can do something that they're going to play with a family, as a family, forever.
Breaking Par is always building on the concept of looking at the game of golf through a different lens. And a lot of that perspective comes specifically from people who are always trying to grow the game. People like Don Ray.
Welcome to Augusta Ranch, the number one short course in Arizona. We're all about neighborly friendly. Are you ready? As a kid at a municipal golf course, there was always a big sign of all the rules. Don't be late, no rain checks, no fivesomes, dot, 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 dot. So we came up with the sign. Here's our course rules.
Come relaxed, leave happy. Rule number one. I love that.
That's the most important one. I just think there's too many rules at golf courses that drive people away. When people come here, we want them to feel welcome. And when they leave, I want them to feel appreciated.
Don Ray takes a whole new approach at growing the game at his course. It's about attracting golfers and non-golfers alike.
I love golf courses like Augusta Ranch. We're the farmers. Did you know that 8% of the population plays golf? Some people find that amazing. When I ask them all the time, how many people do you think play golf? Oh, a lot. 8%. And so why is that? And I think some of them just haven't been exposed to golf. The key is to get them here and open their eyes. Then we started thinking outside of golf in and of itself. It became movie nights on the driving range. It became cornhole tournaments on Friday nights. It became bike rides on the golf course, because anything that we could do to bring family here, I think then they would discover golf. And even when my daughter first came out, Katie, she didn't even swing a club. She drove the golf cart and picked up pine cones. And all of a sudden she associated a golf course with fun, and she never swung a club. I know if I just plant that seed, they'll come back. That's what we do here at Augusta Ranch. We're farmers. We plant the seeds of golf in people, and we try to water them as best we can so that they have a good time for the rest of their life.
Here's the kicker with Don. He didn't start at ground zero with golf. His OG game goes back to baseball.
My dad, he wanted me to play golf so bad, but I love baseball. I got into baseball and I got into umpire. Professional umpire for 9 years, 1,300 baseball games.
From minor league baseball to the familiar brown uniform of your favorite UPS delivery guy.
When you're an umpire, it's a great job to work for UPS. They need Christmas drivers. And then I taught at umpire school every January. And then spring training kicked in March.
Sloan Park, home to the beloved Cubbies, the lovable losers. But before it was a baseball mecca, it was a nine-hole crash course known as Riverview. And it's where Don's UPS truck route drove him to a future in golf.
I delivered to Riverview Golf Course every day. And sometimes I was ahead of all my deliveries and I had to wait to do my pickups. And so I could hit balls during my lunch hour before I started my pickups. Something just drew me to that. And that's why I was like, well, what would it be like to work in the golf business? In a sense, you know, I was resurrected out of baseball into golf, you know, because of Riverview Golf Course. And now Riverview Golf Course got plowed under to be a baseball stadium. So it's crazy to think about that, but.
Mind-blowing irony. From a nine-hole golf course to a nine-inning playground for spring training, and while Sloan Park now sits where Don first dabbled in golf, he happily traded calling pitches to calling the shots.
So I guess you could say, I mean, I went from driving a truck to owning a golf course.
Are you following? The quick history lesson on Ray's background gives this rags-to-riches story a silver lining to those who don't hit the links until later in life.
I didn't play junior golf. I didn't play high school golf. I came to this game when I was 30 years old. That's when I first started cleaning clubs. And so, you know, I'm a 30-year-old working right next to 16-year-olds making $5.50 an hour back in 1998. It was humbling.
A humbling journey that led him straight to a PGA meeting.
I called Don after that meeting and said, Don, you'd be a good board member. You're not afraid to ask the questions. We need that spirit on the board, and you know, relationships start in interesting ways, and so that's how our relationship started.
A prime example of two buds that come from different backgrounds, but the same great game brought them together.
He goes wide. He's not afraid to try things. He's not afraid to ask questions. He's an innovator in the sense that, why can't this work? Why can't we do night golf? Why can't we do some of these things? And he grows his business that way.
Our patrons, they come and they say, hey, what do you think about this? Well, we're not a big management company. It's just me.
Okay.
So when somebody has an idea, it's like, well, let's try it. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. There's a little area there that's always in the shade. What if it was a putting green?
A little extra putting area, literally right off the 19th hole.
Everything is about fun with Don at Augusta Ranch. They even have an official place to settle grudge matches.
And then I got to show you what we do when there's ties.
On the patio of their scratch pub and grill, there's an official tee box set up for a closest to the pin shot over the water to the ninth green. You know I had to take a stab at it.
We'll let him finish.
No, he's waiting for you.
Oh, is he? Okay.
This is breaking par, baby.
Okay. Oh, look at that. Safe
shot. The distance was good.
What a really cool idea. I love this place.
It's not just about injecting as much fun as possible into the game. It's about encouraging the surrounding community to come together as well.
If you ever talk to a resident in Augusta Ranch, they will tell you that this is the sense of community right here. This is the heart of the community. He knows how to utilize 90 plus acres.
I think all the events that we do, they're certainly community events, but it's just, they're almost lost leaders. Because once they're here, I know I can expose them to maybe a putting league. Maybe it's a glow-in-the-dark tournament, right? In minor league baseball, I mean, once again, 1,300 baseball games, they'll try anything. Whether it's Race the Mascot or the Dizzy Bat Races, I mean, they were hilarious. And they don't take themselves too seriously, which I think is an important quality that golf needs to capture a little bit. So yeah, I mean, we need a little bit more minor league baseball in golf.
And golf continues to need a little more Don Ray. I'm glad he left packages and pitches in the past.
Certainly, you know, I didn't know if I was going to make it to the big leagues. And, you know, unfortunately I didn't, but fortunately I didn't. Because there is no doubt this is where I'm supposed to be.
While he loved being a part of America's greatest pastime, he'd much rather pass time creating a comfortable course where new players can familiarize with a game that takes great focus.
The difference between golf and baseball is that in golf you got to play your foul balls. There's just something about golf, isn't it? I mean, there's something we tell everybody, leave it better than you found it. Fix two ball marks. I mean, that's a fundamental of golf. There's no referees out there, right? You gotta keep your own score, and it's up to you to make sure you're playing by the rules.
Rules and regulations aside, it's been a long road for Ray. And his reason for finding the real meaning of the game isn't even teed up just yet.
His next step is to run for Secretary of the National PGA.
The reason I want to become the next president of the PGA of America, which starts with me getting elected as the secretary, is because I'm better in person than on paper. I'm a good cheerleader. And I think right now some of these halftime talks are coming from the parking lot instead of the locker room.
Everybody tells you what they do. Here's a guy that walks the walk. Look at where Don started. Look where Don's at, but look at where Don's going.
The story I have of basically coming to golf as a second career in life is the main reason I want to get elected, to kind of talk about golf the way I see it. And certainly, I love the history of golf. I love the rules of golf. I love all of those things. But I also know that golf needs a little bit of minor league baseball in it. And wouldn't that be cool? Because I think that would be attractive to that 92% that don't play golf. The future of the game of golf is going to be awesome. I mean, start telling somebody, tell a friend and tell everybody, because we have the answer. You should be excited about it. And if you're not telling somebody, you're not doing your job. So get out there, bang the drum, and bring people to a golf course, because it's going to change their life.